Let's talk about the Claisen condensation. So Claisen was a very busy chemist and has a few reactions named after him, but we're talking about the condensation reaction here between an ester that has acidic alpha hydrogens and either itself or another ester. And so let's look at what happens when there's actually just two of the same type of ester and see how the product looks. So what we end up with is the nucleophilic attack of an enolate to the ester that eliminates an alkoxy group to form a beta keto ester. So the ester, the enolate part, so this one forms the enolate, keeps the ester, and then the electrophile, the second ester, forms the ketone. So we say alpha, beta, there's the alpha, beta, keto ester. And so here's the one position, two, three, four. So sometimes you number that way and you'd say it's a 3-4 keto or a 4-keto ester. That being said, between like esters, this is what we get. And we'll look at the mechanism of that in a moment. However, in a cross-Claisen where you have two different esters that are reacting, we simplify things when we have only one of the two has alpha hydrogens. So the one we want to form the enolate has alpha hydrogens, but the electrophile does not. And so here's our electrophile, and we're going to have this solution stirring with base, so OR minus there, sodium methoxide, sodium ethoxide, whatever the R group on the ester is, that's what we want. That's what we want the alkoxide to be, so that we don't have transesterification going on in our mechanism. So we just kind of make these two guys the same by default. All right, so we then add dropwise the electrophile, the nucleophilic enolate forming ester to this solution. We're allowed to use alkoxy groups. This is technically an equilibrium reaction. Here's the line reaction for it. So we're going to add it dropwise, the thing with alpha hydrogens forming the enolate, so it does it slowly and does not self-condensate. Rather, it forms a higher percentage product where the nucleophile and the electrophile are well identified in the reaction. So there's what we would get, and so we can mark, well, here's the phenyl group and the ketone from the electrophile ester, and then the nucleophile ester here that we see with the R2 group as well, we can see that formed here. And so look at that, the enolate again keeps its ester. So whatever is the enolate ester, it keeps its OR group intact. All right, so what if we have a cross-Claisen with alpha hydrogens on both? It's very similar to the aldol in that we're going to add our first ester that we want to form the enolate. We're going to add this dropwise to a prepared solution of LDA and THF so that we form the enolate in entirety, goes to completion. There's no equilibrium going on. So this particular one would form an enolate that looks like this. Okay, and so that's going to go to completion when you add LDA, lithium diisopropyl amide. And so then after that, we add our electrophile dropwise so that we slowly perform this very vigorous reaction, and then we work up with a little bit of acid to make it easier to isolate at the end. We neutralize all that negative base out of solution, so the LDA. Want to probably do that dropwise as well, since it's quite vigorous, like we said. Okay, and so if we look, our enolate ester here that keeps the ester, there it is with its alpha position being attacking our other ester, our crossed group here, and so we lose its ester group, retain the carbonyl, make a beta keto ester in the Claisen. So let's look at the mechanism of the Claisen based on our original example here of this ester, two different esters here. So we take our OR minus, this could be, and let's actually make this concrete, let's lose the R groups here and say, well, what if this was a methyl ester for this compound? We'll put an ethyl group on the other side. So Let's then deprotonate our alpha hydrogens with sodium methoxide. Methoxide is the only thing active here. And let's highlight an alpha hydrogen that will get deprotonated. There it is. Form the enolate. We don't have to worry about kinetic or thermodynamic here because there's only one set of alpha hydrogens on an ester possible. So we know that we can only have one possible enolate. Okay, when that happens, we then again self-condensate. So we got another exactly identical to the starting material here. And we see that when this enolate comes back down, we attack as an electrophile to that position, kicking up the pi bond to a lone pair. And so we want to be careful here. We want to draw out our original ester as is, and then at the alpha position where we just attacked, we want to add in, starting at this carbon, O minus, where the ester, the OCH3, and then we had a methyl group or an ethyl group left over, so we got to add in all those carbons, make sure we got everything. And now we've got a tetrahedral intermediate here that can then return to a ketone here, or a carbonyl compound, eliminate the leaving group of the methoxide. And we will then see, redraw the original in the same orientation so we're not losing track of it. Ketone goes here, ester's gone, what's left over is an ethyl group. So if we mark out where everything came from and count our carbons on our exams, then we won't make a mistake here, but we have a beta keto ester from the Claisen.